Welcome to Women's History Month. This month, I'd like to share with you stories of women and groups of women who have changed my life. And once you hear of their stories, they will also change your lives. The Military Women's Memorial has jump-started their Her Story campaign, looking for our military stories. If you served in any military service during any time frame, regular, reserve, or National Guard, you can enter your information in their database. It's easy. I just updated my information. You just log on to womensmemorial.org and create an account. It's free. Just add your information. My story and your story will then make up the 2 million living women veteran stories that make up America's history. If you have loved ones who have passed on, you may also share their stories. Again, it's womensmemorial.org. National Vietnam War Veterans Day is observed every year on March 29th and is a way to thank and honor the nation's Vietnam veterans and their families for their service and sacrifice. When you hear of Vietnam veterans, who do you think of? The men who valiantly served in country? The nurses who also serve valiantly, keeping the wounded alive and standing with those as they took their last breath? Well, I'd like to introduce you to the untold stories of the non-nurses, women Vietnam veterans, who served in country Vietnam. I first heard of them collectively in Sergeant Major Donna A. Lowry's book titled Women Vietnam Veterans, Our Untold Stories. I remember vividly because it was shortly after that I met a group of them in Phoenix, Arizona. Some came in wheelchairs, many could not travel, but they all were there in spirit, and they were feisty and adamant that we all understood their journeys. Sergeant Major Retired Lowry shares stories and pictures documenting the non-nurses. Amazingly, Sergeant Major Lowry and her dedicated research team found over 850 women, about 700 in the Army, 35 Marines, 12 in the Navy, and 200 in the Air Force. The first member of the Women's Army Corps to serve in Vietnam was Major Anne Marie During in 1962. She had the distinction of being native of North Vietnam, known as French Indochina at the time, and of speaking both French and Vietnamese as her native languages. She arrived March 30th, 1962, to be the first and at that time the only Women's Army Corps officer to serve there. It was the first time she had returned to her native country since leaving as a teenager. Then a major, she was one of the three military women in country. The other two were nurses at a time when the U.S. presence in Vietnam totaled only 5,000 U.S. service members. These women, like their male military counterparts, received no parades welcoming them home. I encourage you to learn more about all the women and men who served in Vietnam, especially the non-nurses who served in country. Other non-nurses wrote about their Vietnam service. Women like Doris Lucky Allen, who served in country October 67 to September 70. Her book, 3 Days Past Yesterday, A Black Woman's Journey Through Incredibility. Or Linda Earls, who served in country May 68 to May 69. Her book, Vietnam, I'm Going. And Carol Ogg, who served March 1971, her book, Fields of Fire. It's been many decades since these women served in Vietnam. Honor their service by finding out more about their journeys. And if you ever get to meet one of these wonderful women, remember to say welcome home and thank you. To learn more about the National Vietnam War Veterans Day, visit VietnamWar50th.com. This month, as we share Women's History Month, we will dive into more stories of women and women's stories. I look forward to seeing you then. Until we meet with intention.